Hey guys, it's Rejections here, and today I've got a Gears of War 2 commentary for you, and I'm playing Guardian on Pavilion. A lot of people may be asking, why are you playing Gears of War 2, the game's so bad? Well, the reason is, I wanted to give the game another chance, because everything deserves a second chance, and I know a lot of people have been having problems with the game, such as shotguns and snipers, and I really had a problem with it when the game first came out, and I know that the developers have been doing a lot of updates since that, to try and sort things out, and they have been doing it and it's worked pretty well. The game's really good now and it's quite fun to play, I've got to admit. The only downfall with it is the amount of people that play it. I think people are starting to come back onto it now since Gears of War 3 is coming out, and it's nice to see that the community is getting back together, because the Gears of War community is just probably one of the best gaming communities ever, I've got to admit that. Although there is a lot of hate on it about people being fanboys and stuff, but it's, you get that in every community. But it's quite a friendly community, and you'll probably see me using the Lancer a lot in this match, because I've got to say something, the Lancer is an amazing gun, and if you don't give it a chance, then there's no point in you really playing the game, because it's not a shotgun game, is it? It's Gears of War, and you're given the Lancer for a reason, and you're meant to use it. I mean, the Hammer Burst is good as well. It's hard to choose which one to use out of the Hammer Burst and the Lancer, but in Gears of War 2, I find the Lancer is more effective on the enemy. It's really good and it takes them down really fast, and once you've got them down, then you can either just execute them or just shoot them if you can do it. So yeah, as you can see, I think that guy in my team was going to steal my kill. But yeah, I wanted to mention one thing. A lot of people have been asking, have you got HDP VR yet? And well, if you're watching this video in 720p, I'm sure you can answer that question yourself. I have got one, and I'm just going to talk about the PVR for a second or two, or a minute or two, whatever. I was going to do an unboxing of it, which I did make, but it turned out quite horrible, and you could see my address and stuff on the video, and I didn't want to show people my address because, well, that's private information really. So yeah, and I ordered the PVR over 2 weeks ago. It cost me over £140, which is close to $200, I think. And I got it from a website, and I even paid for first class delivery so I could get more videos for you guys even quicker. And that should have been there, like, I bought it on a Wednesday, and it should have came on like the Friday or something. It said expected date was the Friday, but it didn't actually come. So I waited until the Friday after that, and that was like 10 days or something later, 9-10 days after it came, and it was actually quite disappointing. So I phoned up the company that I bought it from, and I requested my money back for the postage and packaging and the whole delivery thing, and I actually got it back, so they were really good about that. And once I got it, I was really happy with it. I mean, I opened the box, I was like, yeah, I got a PVR, and I was like, everyone will just love the quality that I'll be bringing for them. So I'm just hoping that this brings a lot of more attention to my videos and a lot of more viewers for it, and as you can tell, it looks really nice quality. And if you've got any like suggestions on how to make it better, then please do say. And I know a lot of people don't get the chance to record their gameplay because maybe they don't have enough money, and I completely understand that. There's a lot of people out there that just be like, oh, you're poor or something, or go get a job. But I mean, like, I don't even have a job, and I've got a reason why I don't have a job. I might mention it in a different video, but a lot of people do get like embarrassed about not having enough money or something to buy a capture device. So I may do my Dazzle DVC giveaway, Dazzle DVC 100. So I might give it away and give people a chance to get their videos out there, and hopefully they can make something with it and entertain people and enjoy themselves while they've got the capture card. And I will give the Dazzle away with the S video cable and all the stuff that you need with it. I'll even give the software away, but if you can't get that to work, then just tell me and I'll try and help you out with it. But that won't be for a little while now, if I decide to give it away at all. I might need it in the near future in case the PVR doesn't work for some weird reason, or I just need it for anything. So if you just keep asking me for a Dazzle giveaway or something, then I might actually do it, and that'd be pretty fun, just to see how many people are interested in it and stuff, and just give people a chance to get their videos out there, because there is a lot of good gamers out there that just can't afford a capture device. Another thing I wanted to mention was Minecraft. A lot of people have been asking, do you play Minecraft? And I did play it once, but I had no idea what to do. I found myself chasing a cow around for about 10 minutes, and then I just deleted it off my hard drive because I had no idea what to do. Chasing cows isn't a really good game for me, but I was thinking about doing an episode, something like Rejections Can't Play Minecraft, and then see how that goes on from there. And I'll probably be commentating over it, of course. So if you want to see a Minecraft episode, then leave a comment or something, and I just want to see how much response I get for it. And as you can see now in the video, I'm the leader, and I actually enjoy being the leader on Guardian, because you've got to try and stay alive, and it makes it more fun, and you can't let the enemy kill you, or that's you just letting your team down. And there you see right now I'm using the Lancer, and it's really effective, even at that range. Another thing is, I promised you guys a COD 4 montage a while ago, and I'm just wanting to let you all know that it's actually being edited right now by my friend. I met him through another friend because he did an edit for him, but there'll be a link in the description for the editor. I think his channel's The Meows or something, I can't pronounce it, but he's a really cool guy, and he changes a lot of things. Like, I've told him to do this and that for the montage, and he's actually like redone a lot of stuff just for me, just for the montage and stuff, and it's just going to look amazing. It is going to be probably the last standard definition video on my channel, because I've got the HD PVR now, and why upload standard def videos if I've got a PVR, you know what I mean? It's just going to be really good, because it's a lot of good clips put together in standard def, and I didn't expect it to be the last standard definition video on my channel, but yeah, that's going to look pretty nasty. Another thing is, I just want to talk about Gears of War in general. As a lot of you should know by now, Gears of War 3 is coming out, I think it's this year, fall this year, I'm not pretty sure, so don't quote me on that one. But Gears of War 3 is going to be an amazing game, and I can just sense it already. And if you enjoy Gears of War videos, then you should definitely stick around, because I'm going to be posting lots of Gears of War 3 videos. I might make a few montages, some commentaries, tips, techniques, stuff like that. If you want to see some certain videos on Gears of War 3, then just feel free to tell me what you want to see, and I'll try and do my best to get it out there for you, because you guys are like a family to me, and I just want to show how much I love you with all these beautiful videos. I just want to talk about Gears of War in general right now. I started playing Gears of War 1 about half a year after it came out, and I just really got addicted to it, and I'm not the sort of person that enjoys playing third person shooters, but Gears of War was just something special, and I just felt like there was something there, and I was really good at Gears of War 1. The sniping on it was just amazing, and I really enjoyed the whole sniping scene when there was guys such as Iceman and Likebot around, and they're still around right now, and they're trying to bring back the Gears of War community, and it's really, I really appreciate what they're doing for the community, because the Gears of War community is probably one of the best communities for gaming, and I know there's a lot of haters in it and stuff, and that has to be changed, but these guys are trying to change that, and I just really look up to them for what they're doing, and I thought it was time to maybe start doing some Gears of War videos and help bring back the community. It used to be really, really good until the standards for the game, like if you were to upload sniping clips or something, the standards would be really, really high. You'd have to get like an on-screen double, then a single or something, so it would be like an on-screen triple, and that's basically just like a triple feed to you COD players that don't understand how to play Gears yet. But I think that if you do have some spare money laying around, then maybe you should just like go to a game shop or something and pick up a copy of Gears of War 1 or Gears of War 2, preferably Gears of War 1 because it's such a better game. I'm sure you could pick it up second hand for maybe £5, which is probably like $10 or something, I don't know, however you guys say it in America. And you should give it a chance, because every game deserves a chance. Even if it's not like one of the biggest mainstream games out there right now, it still deserves a chance, and you should get used to it. I mean, it's not any different from Call of Duty in a sense, because it's the middle of your screen that you used to shoot. If you don't focus on the character and you focus on the middle of the screen, then it's no different from Call of Duty. Because when I play a game, I don't focus on, like, if I'm playing Call of Duty, I don't focus on the gun, I focus on the middle of my screen, and I just focus on where that's going to be shooting the enemy. Focus on lining it up and stuff, Like, as you can see in Gears of War 2 right now, there's a character that's slightly to the left of the screen. I don't focus on that. I focus on where the middle of the screen is, and that's what you've got to do in a game to be good at it. And I find it helps me a lot. And you can probably see it now, I'm using the grenades like a little noob. Just waiting to spawn trap the enemy, basically. But yeah, talk about the middle of the screen for about the 600th time already. That's, as you can see, the crosshair in the middle of the screen right now is where it's where the main part of the game is, like where you have to basically get on the enemy. You have to aim that on the enemy so it's like accurate and it kills them. So if you're not, if you're focusing on like the way your character looks or something, then you're not going to do any good for yourself or your team. And it's all about accuracy and consistency and stuff. And if you can do that, then you're going to be a good player, I'm going to tell you. But if you do have some money laying around, get yourself a copy of Gears of War 1. Learn to play it. If you need any help, then just talk to me and I'll try and make you understand how to play the game, and I'll try and help you understand all the names for like all the sniping shots and stuff. Like, you get the Superman, the Spider-Man and stuff. It's really weird names. But it's really cool. And I just really love it, because if you could imagine playing Call of Duty with the heads exploding like they do on Gears of War, then that would be the best game going, I'm not going to lie. Because it's the sort of gore in Gears of War that makes me love playing it even more, because when you pop someone's head with a shotgun or a sniper, you just see like their brains flying out and stuff, and it's, I know it's not a nice thing to say, but it's really fun to just play it and blow someone's brains out. And I'm sure a lot of you just want to blow someone's brains out. So get a copy of Gears of War and just start playing it. And then I did play Gears of War 1 for a while, and then once Gears of War 2 came out, I actually got it. I pre-ordered it and stuff out of the shops, and then I got it, and I'm not going to lie, I was pretty disappointed in it. The snipers sounded horrible, the shotguns were weak, and it was just a completely different game. The way you moved in the game was completely different, and it felt like you could move more freely on Gears of War 1, and it was more fast-paced, but the Gears of War 2 matchmaking was much better than Gears of War 1. I don't know why, it's just a lot better for matchmaking in Gears of War 2, in my opinion anyway. But I did like stop playing Gears of War 2 after the Gears of War 2 game let me down, and that's when I sort of lost interest in Gears of War 2. But a lot of Gears of War gamers came back and started playing Gears of War 1 again, and that's when I started playing it again, and I just loved it again. And I started making videos ages ago of Gears of War 1, but they didn't get anywhere, so I just stopped playing Gears of War 1, went on to Call of Duty, see how I did in that, and I must say I'm pretty good at Call of Duty. But I'm not going to lie, Call of Duty is an easy game to play, and anyone can play it. 5-year-olds can play it, and you've probably seen like 5-7-year-olds and stuff on YouTube playing Call of Duty games. So it's not really hard to play Call of Duty. Gears of War is more challenging. Because to be good in Gears of War, you've got to get headshots with snipers, and you don't get that on Call of Duty. If you shoot someone in the leg or something in Call of Duty, it just kills them straight away. So it's not that hard on Call of Duty to get a kill. And to be consistent with your kills on Call of Duty, like you've got to be on Gears of War, then it's just completely different, because you got to be consistent on Gears of War and get headshots in Gears of War to be good. On Call of Duty, you just got to be consistent and do some trick shots and shoot them in the legs and stuff to be good. There's a massive difference between skill. But it's not about that, it's about having fun. So if you're bored of Call of Duty, then I'm going to advise you to get Gears of War, because you'll love it. Even if third person shooters are not your game, you'll still love it. So pick it up and get a shot. Anyway guys, this is coming to an end, so I hope you enjoyed this video, and stay tuned for more. Peace!